गुड इवनिंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व ए प्रॉब्लम ऑन ग्राउंड बीम। सो वी हैव प्लान ऑफ द बिल्डिंग। सो डिजाइन ग्राउंड बीम ए बी सी डी ई। द बीम हैव विड्थ 230 मिलीमीटर, फ्लोर हाइट 3 मीटर एंड प्लिंथ हाइट 0.45 मीटर। एज्यूम हाइट ऑफ फ्लोर बीम्स 0.45 मीटर। सो वी विल गिव height of wall as 3 meter only. Use M25 and Fe415. So we have this slab, this plan of the building, and we are interested to design beam A, B, C, D, E. So this is ground beam. So we have that is beam at support and beam at span as rectangular beam only. So we will go higher span in this. So we have CD, which is 6.6 meters. So effective span, we will have 6.6 meters, 6600 millimeter. So accordingly, we will go for trial depth 412.5 millimeters. Now overall depth, we will get 452.5 millimeter. So we will provide 450 mm overall and deep 410 millimeter. This is thumb rule to decide the effective depth D. And therefore, though we have 412.5, we will go little bit lower side because we have low load, and therefore we can go lower side little bit. So we have this capital D 450 and small D 410 millimeter. Load calculation, we have only two loads, that is weight of wall and self weight of beam. So weight of wall 20 into 0.23 into 3, where 20 we have considered unit weight of machinery, and we gives us weight of wall 13.8 kilonewton meter and self weight of beam 2.59 kilonewton meter. So total dead load we will get 16.39 kilonewton per meter. So factored load is 24.6 kilonewton meter. So we have these values 24.6, that is on all spans. Then we will go for calculation of bending moment. So we will have to go for basic method, that we have to go for the moment distribution. So we have this joint BCD. Member, we have BA, BC, CD, CB, CD, DC, D. And then we have BA, we have farther end simply supported, so 3EI by L. And DE also farther end support, simply supported 3EI by L. So all we have, other, all we have, that is 4EI by L. And from this, we are going to get this value as 1.75, 1.61. So we have this value, that is DC. So if we will see DC, then we have same 4EI by L, so 0.61. So we will get this 3EI by L. So this value we will get it as 1.61. So we have this 3EI by L, so this value is 0.75. So 0.75, and this is DC 4EI by L. So 4EI by 4, we will get this value as EI. So this is EI and this is 0.75 EI. So this is correct. So we will have this value actually 1.75 EI. And then accordingly, we are going to get these values, that is distribution factors 0.43, 0.57. 0.62, 0.38, then we have 0.38 for DC, and for DE we will get 0.62. So we have these distribution factors. So now we will go to the bending moment calculations. So we have MF AB, MF BC, minus 32.8, then BA, CB, ED 32.8, CD and DC plus 89.3. So this is minus actually. So we will get MF CD minus, and then MF DC we will get it as plus. Then we will go for moment distribution. So distribution factors we have like this: joint A, B, C, D, E. Then we have minus 32.8, likewise. And then we have release A and E. So we have minus 32.8 plus 32.8. and from this we will get 16.4 minus 16.4, and from this total moment we have these values, and then we will go for distribution of moment, and then we will get it as final moments. So we have these are final moments, and we have these values of final moments that will be in this fashion. Now, once we have these final moments, then we can have next step, that is span moments. These all moments we are going to get support moment, that is BA, BC, then CB, CD, and then DC and DE. These are all support moments. Now we will go for span moments, so need not require to explain. So we have to find value of VA, then VB also we will calculate, and then we will find point of zero shear force where we will get maximum span moment. So 30.38. Similarly, we can go for BC. Then we have for BC. So this is actually VB and VC. So this is B, this is C. So for VB and VC, we have these values as 42.78, 55.62, and then again shear force zero value and maximum bending moment minus 4.95. Similarly, we can go for CD, value of zero shear force and then maximum bending moment. And then we have for DE this value, and that is again we have VD and then we have VE. So this is VD. And then we have this value as BE. And we have these values, and then we will go for shear force zero. And then we will find maximum bending moment. So we have this bending moment, span moment. So we will prepare a table, and in that table we will put all the values. That is values that is at support and values at span. Now we will consider maximum value of the moment that is at support D. And we will check depth for bending moment consideration. So we know Ku max for Fe415.48 and then Ru max 3.45, and we will get this value 305.51 millimeters, which is less than 410 millimeters, therefore okay. Then we will go for reinforcement in this. So now reinforcement, we have, as it is rectangular beam, as we have ground beams over here, no slabs are there. So beam is rectangular at span also and at support also. And then we will get value 230B, and then from this we will get value of AST 213.34 millimeter square. So we will provide two bars of 12 millimeter diameter, which will be 226 millimeter square, greater than 213.34. Similarly, we will find a one at support moment, which is 42.15 at B. Same formula we have, and then value we get as 300.81 millimeter square. So here we will go for three bars of 12 millimeter fine. And then we can find values of AST required for all. Span already we have calculated. Support we have 300.81 already calculated. Then for span minus 4.59. So we are going to provide minimum two bars at top. Now here tension is at top. Then support we have C 67.83. Required steel is 502.89, and accordingly we will provide number of bars required at span and at support. Similarly, we can go for span CD and DE, and for span CD and DE we are in this mesh. So we have these values in this way, and then we are going to get this AST provided for this in this mesh. Now we will go for check for deflection, and we have 16.1 less than 26. And then check for development length. So we have taken this at DU, and that is at ED, and then we have this will be LD required, and then we will provide this 1.3 M1 by VU plus L0, and we will get 561.93 greater than 483.55 millimeters. And then we will go for check for shear. So we have to check at supports. So we will have 82.12, which is maximum in CD, and we will have critical section B by 2 plus D, and from this we will get value of VUD 69.21 kilonewtons. So knowing this value, we will calculate VUC plus VUR minimum. So percentage of steel, if we will calculate, we will have 0.24%, and for which we have TUC 0.353 newton per mm square. and then from this we are going to, here we have two bars of 12, and accordingly we have calculated this value, and we will have it as 0.24. And then VUC we have calculated, which will be 33.29 kilonewton, and VUSE minimum 37.72 kilonewton, which will give me VUC plus VUSV minimum, which is 71.01 kilonewton, greater than 69.21 kilonewton. So we have to provide only minimum shear reinforcement throughout. And then we have to find value of SV by using a formula, 0.87 FYASV upon 0.4B. So we have second criteria, 0.75D, which is 307.5, and 300 mm third. We have to take minimum of the three, and we have 6 mm at 20 millimeter center to center as shear reinforcement. Then we have shown here that reinforcement. So we have throughout two bars of 12 as anchor bars at top. Then we have AB, that is two bars, 12 at bottom. Then we have three bars at support B, two of we are already available. So one we will provide extra at top. Then we will have BC, two bars of 12 plus one bar of two bars of 16. So this is for span BC. So for span BC, actually we have two bars of 16 plus we have one bar that is of 12. So we have one bar of 12 plus two bars of 16. Then we have at support C, two bars 12 available. So we will provide one bar of 20 tor. And then we have for CD, so for support C actually, we have this value that is 1 meter, which will be 0.25 Elvin. And on this side also 0.25 Elvin. Now, if we will go to CD, then we have two bar of 12 tor. Then at support D, we have two bars of 16. So one we will curtail, that is at 0.15 L, and another we have at 0.25 L. Because if we will have one 16 plus 2 12, then that is more than 16, and which is beyond 15 L, and therefore we can curtail one bar over here, that is of at 0.15 L from face of the supports. And then we have these values, that is of 16 tor, which is 1.65 left and 1 meter right, whereas 1 meter left and 0.6 meter, which will be second bar of 16 tor. And then in DE, we have two bars of 12 tor. So likewise, we have this reinforcement, and this is our stirrups, which are 6 mm at 220 mm center to center. And then if we will take section 1-1, then we have section 1-1 in this way. That is at support, and then at span we have taken a section, and at span we have section is in this fashion. So we have these sections at support and at span moments. So this is all about your ground beam. So today we will stop here only. So thank you.